Swedish family is, let's say, mainstream, feel welcome. But on the other hand, the ones now occupying the migrants still feel that it's still their space. So it was very interesting. My involvement was studying the patterns we were also using visualization for the results, so we could see people from different backgrounds, where they go, where they overlap, what they need. So I think that we did good.
I also would like to add that this green capital, it's somehow separated from the actual investment program as the municipality. And we think I
local level, that's for us. So
black and white, what we need to discuss, which means we try to look for solutions on the problems that we found this morning. So the idea is to make three groups. Each group will have just a few problems and try to look for solutions of that problems. Maybe we will do like this morning, first group, second group, third group, first, second, third group, first, second, third group, first, second, third group, first group. Okay, everybody knows the group?
Yeah.
Fine. So, Marie, maybe I will let you just...
and we decide about problems.
You want to choose.
Yeah.
Okay. You can choose. I will briefly remind you of what are the challenges that were found in the session from this morning. So here
you have maybe 1 more minute. I will let them just make the groups compact.
Oh, yeah.
This morning, so we have 2 minutes more. So please, maybe let's say first group here, second group there, third group there, and fourth group here. So just three groups, yes. Okay, yes. Sorry. So let's say first, second, and third group here. So it will be first, second, and third group here. Sorry, it's my mistake. Not able to count anymore.
For attention.
This morning, I quickly typed down, there were 5 groups this morning, and they each need to find 5 challenges. And I quickly typed down what were the ideas, so I can tell you again, but you pick 1 or 2 ideas from this morning, mm-hmm. and you work on it. So the first group said that there were a problem with the traffic between Sofia and the town or villages around it. It was keywords, there would be commuters, because a lot of people work in Sofia, so how to deal with that huge traffic. A lack of intermodal solutions, there's no connection between different kinds of transport. lack of communication between several authorities and also service providers, there's not a lot of people who work together. A major challenge was lack of meaningful goals about how mobility should be defined in the city. So maybe there's on the long-term vision, there's some work to define a group approach, and that in the moment is not the case. No long-term strategies in a holistic point of view. Second group was about the mentality of the people. They are willing to drive a car, but they're not so much willing to use transport or public transport. And the question is how to change mentality, behaviors, or perception of the cities and what is sustainable and what is not. Also, something about the organization of the subway. that the rest needs to be adapted also. There's no actual pedestrian street, no walking area, or it's difficult to have a pedestrian zone where people can walk around. So, and what came this morning, I don't know who said it, street are for cars, not for people. So maybe it's interesting to think about that. Parking spaces, infrastructure problem. Sofia was designed to hold 500,000 people and now it's well above 1.5 million. So maybe it's something to discuss here.
Yeah.
So thinking about parking spaces. Monitoring and controlling. People maybe there might be sanctions. There was a discussion about sanctions. What parking spaces are not respected in my question is, do we need sanctions or do we need more education? Maybe that's a few question. Lack of good sidewalk, parking cars. Traffic, there were falling roof force. There were a question of many people start and finish work at the same time. So maybe there's some kind of management of traffic there or population moves. Flexible working hour solution or something like that. So what to do with the daily commuters? And also people have problem planning their trip because they don't have, they lack of internal model solutions. So a good connected different kind of transport, that is again. And also communication or information about it. Maybe people don't know that there is this station that is connected with bike use or something, maybe they need information about it. Also for people who don't have access to internet, there was a question of, okay, elderly or maybe other kind of people that don't have access to that information. Develop bicycle lines, proper bicycle lines, not only just painted ones, but also dedicated lines. Make it attractive. Working places are concentrated in a part, in some area of the city. Maybe we can think about decentralization to kind of have an influence of also people fluctuation, people movement. We need more trams and subway stations was also one of the things. The last book said there was a big level of motorization. It's very cheap to get a car in Sofia. You can have a car everywhere, and there was also the stereotypes of car that it was difficult to get a car before with the minis regime, but now it's very accessible also, if I understood correctly. Some part of the cities don't have public transport at home, or outside the cities, and the people don't have another choice than just to take a car. They don't have access to transportation in their proximities. Yeah, connection between rural and urban cities. So, some ideas, you pick two. And you think about that. What are the solutions to improve those challenges? So solutions, what kind would you like to have? What kind do you wish for? Which approach? Is it architecture approach? Is it infrastructure approach? Is it social approach? Is it educational approach? You choose. On which level? Is it on the on the street, on a neighborhood, on a city, on a regional approach, you choose, on level. What kind of actors would you need to put that solution into a concrete solution? And how to turn it, if you take a global perspective, how to turn it into an instrument or methodology, and can it be transferable for your other European cities? You have 30 minutes.
Okay.
It's a lot of.
I can add something to this thinking about the solution.
You have already.
We have to think about maybe not some kind of very big and revolutionary solution for the whole society, but in case we have a long-term goals and we have to make the first steps. Little steps to make it possible. What are the possible solutions in this situation in Sofia right now? What is the first steps to get to the bigger long-term goal?
Some specializations, maybe research individual, that's the way people get acquainted with transportation planning. But even beyond the transportation planning.
In the real urban environment in Sofia. So we need a really transparent monitoring process.
Not to support them if a city or region
walk on the street, where these immigrants settled here in the center, just for 5 minutes maybe. It's enough, and then we will go to some of the city parks through the center. We will explain if you are interested in something. I think that it could be good to end this walking earlier, to have your own time for some hours, a couple of hours. And then at the evening we will have a final dinner together to say goodbye. Well, I will ask you to take off toys just in Bulgaria, because for our team, да съберете техниката или и да я качите горе в кабинета на директорката. Значи всичко каквото има наше и на Валерий също. Разбрах се, да, с секретарката и да я качим там.